6:45.
Did anybody else witness that debacle last night between Blackrock Rovers and Leitrim Town? I mean, it has to be one of the most unusual games of soccer ever played in the last couple of years.
You don't want to be late for your first day.
Rovers had four of their players, including the goalkeeper, sent off for fighting after 10 minutes, and then Leitrim scored 14 goals after that. The 15th goal was an own goal by Rovers captain Eddie Kirwan, who, apparently very frustrated at the course of the game, slammed the ball into his own net during a kickout. Poor Eddie was substituted shortly afterwards, and the bad news didn't end there for Rovers.
It's your gran.
It's only me.
Watching you school bag.
I hope he gets on well now in his new school. He'll all be green with envy because of his lovely new school bag. Good old Grant.
Okay, guys. Over on the right there, could you move in a little bit, please? All right.
Same time tomorrow, then.
I know young Philip here will fit right in with his new class. Bullseye! Come here, boy!
Okay, listen up. We've got a new boy joining us today. I'd like you all to say a big hello to Philip Maguire.
Just their way of saying hello. It happened to me when I was in school. You'll soon settle in. That's it. You'll be all right.
Cain Ball, come in the hame yoga, got son of saucer, got Cain law. Mark bean seed, a connoisseur, the Cale, pay a traffic on ground. Of Nemar Sin on scale of Gumsa, nor a grab of free, or is Fada on a hale, a wee mead, got him law.
Keep away from that statue! Bastards!
Your homework is an example of solidified ignorance!
O'Toole, the tomato is not a nocturnal animal.
E minus.
Mooney. Oh, Mooney. Have a guess, Mooney.
A D.
Stop carding yourself, Mooney. You wouldn't get a D if I multiplied your score by 10. You got your homework wrong by 96%.
Is that good?
Philip Maguire. B plus. Well, it's nice to see a seed of intelligence in this desert of brainlessness. Good work, Philip. Your colleagues have much to learn from you. What have you done yet?
So, anything exciting happened today? The principal of your school was telling me they have a great reputation for sports. Have you tried any?
I do a lot of running. Remember when Dad was here? He had a problem he'd sorted out.
The last thing he sorted out was the TV license.
He got 5 years for that.
Then you cut out the shape of the wings with this mark you've already drawn with your stencil. Then you slot the wings through the gap in the fuselage. And then we're ready to fly.
Thank you, Philip. Very impressive.
Now, Robbie MacDonald, your turn. Tell us about your hobby.
You know, maybe you could ask them if you could play football with them. They might be sure to someone.
Coolie, Mom.
Good lad.
When you walk a storm. Hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm, there's a golden sky. And the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind. Walk on through the rain. Though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, walk on, with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone.
Thanks, Pat.
Okay. Thanks, Mr. Daddy. Take these.
I'll send you a postcard.
Yeah,
good luck.
Yeah, take it easy.
Here we are, Frank.
You! We're ill! The boys are back in health!
Help me.
Today praised the actions of the brave Dublin taxi man who foiled an attempted escape from Mountjoy prison of a man they described as violent and dangerous. Caroline Hughes has this report.
Desi Geraghty is the toast of Dublin's taxi ranks tonight after single-handedly preventing the escape of prisoner James Maguire. Maguire, a former supermarket manager,
is
has been jailed
now
for the vicious assault and battery of a TV license inspector.
There he is!
In a vicious struggle, Mr. Geraghty sustained several injuries.
Are you right? No, at this stage of the game, Muggs, I'm thinking this goes out for escaping out of here. So I come flying up on the taxi, pop out your man, say, hey, come here. That's when you chose the dick. Before I know where you are, the pairs are rolling on the ground. I'm getting the better of him. He's a big... Basically what happened.
And what does your family think of all this?
Why should they kiss me and missus? Why should they think
say if they try it once, they'll try it again and keep on trying it until they get it right.
Ma, it was an accident, okay?
Well, I'm not talking about anyone. If they want to do themselves in, there's nothing we can do to stop them.
Ma!
All right, all right. You can't keep an eye on them all day and every day. You'd end up stringing yourself up.
Ma, please.
Look at poor Betty Purcell's husband. To kill himself four times. And just when they thought he was over it, he takes the dog out for a walk one night and jumps into the canal.
Ma, shut up or get out. We have talked it all out. It's okay now.
Oh, I won't say another word. Just after I get him that lovely new school bag.
Shut up! Shut up, you old bitch! I hate that school bag! I'd love to stuff it up your wrinkly old hole.
Don't you dare ever speak to your gran like that again.
There's language for you.
And you, get out of this bloody house or Jesus, I'll swing for you.
I know now where he got it from. Oh, you needn't worry about me. I can find my own way out. But that fella needs a good hiding. And give her one too while you're at it. There's something strange about that.
No, Muldoon. 7 plus 7 is 14. I want you to multiply 7 and 7.
7 and 7?
Yes. No! I just told you! Philip Maguire! Ah, and you must be the lovely Mrs. Maguire. What can I do for you?
I want a word with these boys. In private, if you don't mind. Get out! This is a lesson in the difference between goodness and badness. About how it's so much better to be nice to someone than it is to be nasty. You. What's your name? Deco. Right, Deco. If I was to make you a present of this cake, that's me being nice. And you'd say thank you very much, Mrs. McGuire. That's very kind of you. On the other hand, if I was to grab you by the hair and ram your face into this cake, now that's not very nice at all, is it? Right, Deco. This is Philip. Now, it's not hard to be friends with him. But all you can do is push him around. You and your football. Well, I'll show you football. It hurts when people are nasty to you, doesn't it, Deco? It'd be so much better if they could be nice. Do you understand me? Does anyone here not understand me? Good. That's the end of the lesson for today, then. See you tonight, Philip.
Sorry about that. She's not like that all the time. She's been under a lot of pressure since my dad was sent to prison.
Hi, Philip. I'm Deco. I got a game of football on this time. We can score in the gap and it's really weak. Yeah!